What if we just accepted that diet culture is way worse for us than some frickin' spaghetti? Yeah, well, what if you just put some clothes on? Hey, yo, it's your boy Zoobs, and today we are going to make fun of some fatties for being childish. You know, not because they're fat, but because they are childish. If you want to join Z Squad, just click that subscribe button and the notification bell. Anyway, let's get on with it.
Is the fat acceptance movement and the body positivity movement part of the same movement or separate? I'd love to have a conversation about this. If anyone would like to help me with this, please let M know. I think it would be a good conversation.
They are separate. Body positivity is for people who have things that affect their body that are incurable. Obesity is curable. Yeah.
They!
If you gain weight and your clothes do not fit, you must lose weight to fit back into them. Use the clothes that do not fit as motivation.
That's bunk! If you gain weight, but bigger clothes, keeping the clothes that do not fit does not usually serve as motivation, but as a constant some reminder that our bodies are not acceptable to us, aka
hey, stop.
Yeah, if you are so big that you can't have clothes, then you need to lose weight. And also, triple XL, why is that even a size? That should not even be a size, but thanks to capitalism, it is. Gotta love capitalism making money off of obesity.
The BMI scale was developed in the 1800s when Canadian was still recommended as a health supplement.
Yeah, well, if it was used, it may have been invented when cocaine was used for health purposes. Now cocaine is not used for health purposes, yet BMI is still here. That means it work. Oh man. How many fingers am I gonna get with the new finger guns sprite?
I went for fish, and my nurse put here that I'm an ED therapist said, oh my god, everyone's been eating and eating during COVID. They come in and are unrecognizable. Okay, so what if they did? So what if people decided to self-soothe with food while our world turned upside down?
Oh my god. Systematic reviews and meta-analyses overwhelmingly show that obesity is associated both with a higher risk for intensive care unit, or ICU, admission and poor outcomes for COVID-19. Probably not a great idea to soothe with food.
And reviews also show that doctors are disgusted by the fat patients and give them poor treatment. And so if we care about large body patients, we should care to reduce weight stigma above all else. No, we, particularly those with influence, should not be promoting into normalizing using food as a psychological crutch during a pandemic when it will directly worsen the prognosis of both COVID-19 and other illnesses. Nothing at all to do with stigma. Reality is not
fat-phobic. What we know directly that fat people or those medical professionals are deemed less to survive are being delayed or denied care.
Obesity itself significantly worsens the prognosis and long-term consequences of COVID-19 and many other illnesses. I'll send you the links if you like. Promoting a course of action that will directly harm those who follow is spectacularly irresponsible, to say the very least.
She's describing non-human behavior. No one is tobacco to serve her controlling
Jake's concern trolling. What the frick? Oh my god! These people are way more far gone than I thought.
Concern trolling is fatphobic and harmful. I understand that's probably a nice
self-soothing by overeating, thus directly harming yourself and meaning your outcomes if you do catch COVID-19 are likely to be much worse, is not normal human behavior. Promoting and normalizing it is harmful and horrendously irresponsible.
Please go eat your dry food patch or whatever joyless meal you have planned for yourself. And leave Red alone and learn to read the room.
Oh my god. Did I fail to agree with the conscientious groupthink? I'm horrified, I tell you. Horrified. I will never live this down.
Since POV aligns with NHS propaganda, you agree with the groupthink. If you ever want to learn how fat phobia isn't about health at all, but rather a means of using the body to validate race, class, and gender prejudice, I recommend this book.
Yeah. A single book. Yeah, that book probably really sucks. Yes, if the NHS, World Health Organization, Cancer Research Fund, Lancet, Nature, and all medical professionals agree, that must be propaganda, right? Much better to listen to a random person selling unsubstantiated crud with some buzzwords and grotesque appropriation of anti-racism.
Most of those research studies are funded by corporations that sell science, make diet drugs and weight loss surgery devices, and otherwise profit from the diet industry. B2W, the diet industry is committed to making people fat, not thin. If diets, pills, WLS worked, they'd go broke.
So your claim is the NHS, WHO and WAF, and all the doctors and researchers who have published peer-reviewed studies in high-impact scientific journals are lying
about the damaging effects of obesity for nefarious financial reasons. And you think the NHS is funded by the diet industry?
Man, people think any industry is bad.
Okay, one. Self-soothing. That is really childish to say. Two. Doctors are disgusted by their fat patients. Wow. Did these people have this cartoonesque image of doctors as shallow high school bully Chads or Stacys? Do they really think that doctors did not outgrow the "you fat people suck" mentality? I mean, they went through a frickin' decade of scientific schooling just... I mean... Next point. Three. Those that are deemed less likely to survive by medical professionals. Aw, man. That's like... applying some sort of "everything is a social construct" and stuff. And it's pretty much decided by a privileged ruling class and stuff. And applying that stuff to the real world makes it just leads to disaster. Four, less likely to survive by medical professionals are denied or delayed care because why would you freaking treat someone who will die anyways? Five, those days are free by the diet industry. Wow. Oh my god. Oh my god, that is freaking hilarious. An author is going to have to declare where they got their funding from. Especially if there will be a conflict of interest. And a paper that is funded by freaking Beachbody is not going to be published in any journal that is even half serious. And also, you should try losing weight does not equal try diet pills and diet products. You're not going to hear a doctor or researcher even entertaining the idea of any diet products, because diet products are scams. Doctors discourage using diet products. All they recommend is a healthy diet and regular exercise. Do you know what exercise is? And also, not even going to touch the implication that the entire international science community has been in cahoots for 100+ years to fabricate daily papers about obesity being bad just to dunk on poor/black/female people. Just to freaking dunk on minorities in general. Like, Without a single person blowing the whistle, even though many doctors and researchers are women, people of color, and people who came from poor backgrounds. Like, other countries exist. America is not the only country. And also, dry food pellets? Yeah, like there isn't any freaking alternatives to freaking McDonald's or Burger King or... You know, that's just extremely stupid. Like, Pink does know that fruits exist, right? Fruits are healthy, and they are super delicious.
You haven't messed up because where organs are held. You should reduce it. It can have effects on ovaries and stomach.
Girl, do you even muscle well?
I wish people had the same age to combat fat phobia and weight stigma and to do racism, homophobia, etc. If you're fighting for people's rights to exist in their bodies as they are, then you have to work on challenging fat phobia.
Racism doesn't have a reason. Homophobia doesn't have a reason. Quote unquote fat phobia does have a reason. Because, yeah, fat phobia doesn't even exist. What are you even talking about? Why?
Corn virus has killed 9 out of 66.6 million people yesterday. Obesity kills 330,000 a year, or 82 people per day. We're all running around wearing masks imposed by the same government that was giving half price McDonald's a fortnight ago.
Oh my god, whenever I see the word Fortnite, I just think of the game. You know, vet told us our dog was overweight. Was walking downstairs and I hear my mam say, "Don't mind that vet, you just big boned," while feeding the dog slices of deli ham. Oh my god. I think I know why your dog is obese.
Very dejected after an awful Zoom meeting with a not anymore potential PhD advisor. The entire conversation was supposed to be focused on research related to community-based mental health care, but she tacked on, "Oh, we also tackled the obesity epidemic."
Why the frick is obesity censored?
He's actually in a group for mental health care, blah, 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 blah. So that's great. I'm just sitting at my desk with a snack trying to gas myself up, giggity. Can't picture because it's a whole mood.
Yeah, that cat is kind of a mood.
Oh man, it's another myth versus truth thing.
Myth.
Diets only fail because people can't stick to them.
Fact. Most people regain all of the weight they lost, regardless of whether or not they continue the same diet / exercise behaviors.
And I am not even gonna bother to read that entire paragraph because this video is already long enough. Also, as someone who has never been skinny and also does not really like exercise, I think I...
seem okay because I'm because I'm definitely not gonna get fat ever. And yeah. And I think it's because whenever I work on something, I just forget about food and everything else other than what I'm working on.
Is that a dish?
The obesity pandemic.
Do this.
Considering the obesity from your vocabulary, not only can it be incredibly triggering, but this word is feared as a slur by many within our community. In fact, many doctors and eating disorder specialists have refrained from using it for this very, very reason. Instead, simply say weight or size.
Wow. You wanna change the vocabulary because because when you hear the word obesity, your insignificant little feelings get hurt. I don't even know you. Do you really think I care about your feelings? No. I don't know who you are. Your feelings couldn't be any less significant to me. Why don't you just grow up and find out that the entire world does not have to care about you. Society is not going to change for a single insignificant speck in space. I know it sounds a bit harsh, but it's true. In the wise words of Silver the Hedgehog, I am an optimist, but I am also a realist.
You literally cannot undereat and then not crave food. It's impossible. Humans are biologically wired to crave what food when starving. Undereating is starvation to the primal brain. It was designed to feast after a period of famine.
Oh my god. Whenever I'm not eating something, I am just... I don't really feel very many cravings. And if I do, I pretty much just hold off those cravings until... Get food? You see, the thing is, I don't really feel like I need breakfast, lunch, or dinner. I occasionally eat dinner, and I barely eat breakfast or lunch. Pretty much it's all snacks, and yeah, I pretty much just live on snacks, and yeah, I guess that's why I'm thin. But anyway, that was r/fatlogic. If you enjoyed, leave a like and comment about the part that you enjoyed. If you wanna join Z Squad, then subscribe and ring that bell, or check out the subreddit and join it. Links in the description, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.